In the final topic in your chapter 2, section A, work energy theorem, this is 2b, I'm sorry, it's work energy and theorem. So in your work energy theorem, it simply states that whenever a body is in motion, in that case, if I'm going to apply a force to the body, then the body's kinetic energy increases. It means the kinetic energy is changing. So this work done is equal to the change in its kinetic energy. So now consider an object which is at this point and it is moving with the initial velocity u, and in the same direction I'm going to apply a force. So because of this force, the object's velocity is changing. So let me note that as your final velocity. So after applying this force, what will happen? The object's velocity is changing, and it is also shows a displacement till some distance. Okay, it shows a displacement till these meters. Let me note as S. Okay, their displacement is noted as S. So because of this force, the object is moving along this direction. Therefore, I can say this force is nothing but work done. This work done is also induced in producing a change in its kinetic energy. So W is equal to delta KE. So delta K means change in its kinetic energy. You apply a force, there is a change in the velocity, and because of which the object is moving a further distance, this force and displacement can be together brought into one quantity, that is your work done. So this is your work energy theorem. You apply force and it displaces an object which is nothing but work, and because of this displacement there is a change in kinetic energy. So it is your work.